I'd go down all the time to when Buffy was in town to watch her play. And one of the things that amazed me about her, she used to wear flamenco shoes at that time, like a kind of with a little heel. And she would stand on one foot with her leg cocked up behind in the classic old movie kiss position, you know, when a girl lifts up one leg with her eyes closed. And she never banged her nose on the microphone. That amazed me. I'd think, God, you know, because I used to sing with my eyes closed, and I always banged my nose against the microphone. So I was very impressed with the ballet as well as her writing, because there weren't many women writing songs at that time. Buffy was building a repertoire, and her songs were intelligent, well-crafted, you know, and she was a stunning performer. She was very instrumental because she began to perform my music. My music began to travel away, you know, so she enabled it to go out to a wider audience. And tearful at the falling of a star. And then told her management to, she brought me into that stable, which was very generous because the folk community was extremely competitive.
I mean, there were a lot of good singers around singing folk songs, and, you know, and it was great, and it was nice as far as it went. But what really lit me up was to hear somebody doing something so original. So, man, I carried her tape around in my purse for a long time. I played it for everybody. Finally, I played them for a guy who was managing me for a while. His name was Joel Dean, and he wasn't really interested, but the other guy in the office, Elliot Roberts, he heard it right away, and, of course, he became Joni's manager and built a huge career with her.
The most time I spent with her was in Hawaii, and they were raising Christmas trees in the most beautiful place with waterfalls in the distance when it rained. It was 7 waterfalls, I think, after a hard rain. To her, I remember her telling me this was her sacred, special place.